In the mural itself, it's very clear that there is a white priest and a white nun who is holding an indigenous baby. There is a residential school in the background and obviously a grieving indigenous family who has just had their child removed from them. For anybody, that is completely gut-wrenching.
A petition now targeting this mural at the Grandin LRT station near the Alberta Legislature. It's asking for the artwork to be moved immediately.
I definitely don't think it's something that needs to be hidden. But I also don't think that it should be in such a public area where the people who are hurt and offended by it need to walk by and see that every single day.
Back in 2011, the City of Edmonton, along with various community groups, discussed concerns with the 1989 painting. A decision was made to keep the mural and to surround it with updated artwork from Indigenous voices. Artist and current city councillor Aaron Paquette was among those who contributed. Paquette declining an on-camera request today, but tweeted that a younger generation is asking these same questions is fantastic, and I hope they discover the difficult community work that we engaged in 7 years ago. However, the councillor says he would consider changing the LRT stop from Grandin to Reconciliation Station to help contextualize the artworks. Jade Bologna, who started the petition, is not Indigenous herself, but several of her family members are, including her husband and children. That prompted her to speak up and question the mural.
So I don't think that the mural needs to be destroyed. Maybe it can be moved, as a commenter on the petition said, moved into a museum or something with a story about, you know, the genocide of the Indigenous people.
A letter recently was sent to City Council requesting, as part of reconciliation, if perhaps they could consider using Indigenous names for Edmonton's new wards. A public hearing will be held on this Tuesday next week. From Edmonton, Cheryl Tasaskew, City News.